Welcome to Whiteboard Programming, where we simplify programming with easy to understand whiteboard videos. And today I'll be sharing with you what is SAP SD. For starters, SAP SD or SAP Sales and Distribution Module is a core functional module that allows organizations to store and manage customer and product related data. The module is specially designed to facilitate various business processes in an enterprise, which include customer master or material master data, sales order, deliveries, pricing, billing, and credit management. Working in conjunction with other modules, SAP SD enables an order-to-cash cycle business process. In a typical cycle, SD generates a sales quote and the customer then places the sales order. Once done, the goods are picked from warehouse or production facility and shipped to the customer. Then an invoice is sent with the order and the accounts receivable settles the payment with the customer. Here, each step in the process generates transaction in the SD module, which then generate further transaction in other ECC modules. The SAP SD consists of several submodules that can be configured to handle specific functions in the module. These include SAP SD MD, that is master data, in which SAP SD user has master data that tracks each and every transaction within the data. The SD master data comprises of both customer and material records, record of the price conditions, and credit management. This module includes processes of order and cash specifically. Next, SAP SD BF, that is basic functions. SAP SD configuration results in effective process across all basic functions involved in sales and distribution area. Here, examples of basic functions can be pricing, output, etc. Next, SAP SD SLS, that is sales. As the term suggests, SAP SD sales handle the minute details of every sale that is taking place in the organization. From recording the product to customer details, pricing, feedback, and the sales process, everything is tracked through this module. Next, SAP SD SHP, that is shipping. We all know that sales are closely related to shipping and delivery. A product needs to be rightly shipped and delivered to the customer in order to make a happy customer experience. There are different methods of shipping, and this module tracks each product used for each delivery. The entire process from being shipped to delivered or returned back is recorded through this module. Next, SAP SD TBA, that is transportation. This component works hand in hand with shipping, and as the mode of transportation for each product differs a lot, this module keeps a track of all the transportation data that is happening within the organization. Next, SAP SD FTT, that is foreign trade. This component helps the department to handle the data related to foreign trade, including both in imported and exported products. This module works best for enterprises involved with trade relations across nations. Next, SAP SD BIL, that is billing. Billing is a key part of any transaction, we all know that. Consumers prevail the choice of either paying through online media or else through cash on delivery. This particular module keeps a track of all that billing data in an appropriate manner. Next, SAP SD CAS, that is sales support. From selling a product to maintaining it for a process, customers constantly interact with the sales team. The data exchange between sales team and the customers while delivering the support for a product is recorded and reported through this module. So you must be wondering by now, there are so many modules, but what are the characteristics of SAP SD module? Well, to say some of the most important characteristics of SAP SD module include, number 1, it implements business processes used in selling and billing of goods and services. Number 2, it integrates data flow to remaining modules of SAP. Number 3, it offers multilingual and multi-currency features, that is, several languages can be used and conversion between currencies is automatic. Number 4, adaptable functionality. Number 5, pricing flexibility. That is, in SD you can create complex pricing schemes that are dependent on customers, goods being sold, special promotions, etc. Rebate processing options are also very sophisticated and comprehensive for any administrator. Number 6, simple order entry. The user can enter basic order details all on one window. From this window, there is simple access to all levels of the order, namely header, item, and schedule line information. Number 7, comprehensive reporting. The sales information system allows data to be stored, consolidated, and reported upon by user in a variety of formats. Number 8, effective batch processing of orders, shipment, and other sales documents based on order types, customer, or material. With that, I hope this video was helpful to you and served value. If you love my content, be sure to smash that like button, and if you haven't already subscribed to the channel, please do, as it keeps me motivated and helps me create more content like this for you.